In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Geometry free worksheet, Circumference and Areas of Circles. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Now, in this video, we're going to complete the first set of directions, which states to find the area of each. And we're going to use your calculator's value of pi, rounding our answer to the nearest tenth. So quickly, the area formula for a circle is area equals pi times r squared, where a represents area and r represents the radius, and pi, our calculator's value of pi, is usually the exact value, or as close to the exact value as it can get. However, if your calculator does not have the pi button, pi, we can round to 3.1416. So use 3.1416 as pi's rounded value. Now let's look at number one. In number one, they tell us that the radius, r, is equal to 12 inches. So our area is going to be in inches squared. So area A equals pi, which is 3.1416, if your calculator doesn't have the pi button, times our radius of 12 inches squared. So this will be pi times 12 squared is 144, and inches times inches, or inches squared, is inches squared. So now we're going to take pi and multiply that to 144. And in doing so, we get 452.38, which rounds to 452.4, and that's inches squared for area. And if your calculator doesn't have pi, type in 3.1416 and multiply that by 144, and you will get 452.39, which still rounds to 452.4. And again, our units for area in number one is inches squared. In number two, I'll rewrite the area formula until we're comfortable using it. Area equals pi times r squared, where in number two, r is 14 kilometers. So area A equals pi times 14 kilometers squared. So that's going to be pi times 14 squared, which is 196, times kilometers squared. So essentially, we could rewrite pi times 14 kilometers squared as pi times 14 kilometers times 14 kilometers. So you can see that the 14 is multiplied to itself, so that's 14 squared, and the kilometers, the units, will also be squared. So we'll take pi and multiply that by 196 to get 615.75, which rounds to 615.8, and that's kilometers squared. 615.8 kilometers squared is the area in number two. And number three, area equals pi r squared. Our r is now 9 meters. So area equals pi times 9 meters squared, which if you want to, you can write as pi times 9 meters times 9 meters. And this m is not a variable, it is our unit, meters. So that's going to be pi times 81 meters squared. And 81 times pi will give us 254.46, which rounds to 254.5, and that's meters squared for the area in number three. Area equals pi r squared. R in number four is 11 centimeters, so we'll have pi times 11 centimeters squared. So that will be pi times 11 squared is 121, so 121 centimeters squared. Pi times 121 will give us 380.13, which rounds to 380.1, and that's centimeters squared for the area. Now in the next four problems, numbers 5 through 8, they no longer give us a diagram. However, they give us all the information that's needed for the area of the circle. Because remember, area is equal to pi times r squared, where our radius is r. So if our radius is 2.6 inches, then area is equal to pi times 2.6 inches, and that quantity squared. So that will be pi times 2.6 squared is 6.76, so 6.76 inches squared. And when we multiply 6.76 by pi, we'll get 21.23, which rounds to 21.2, and remembering our units, inches squared. In number 6, our radius is given to us as 34.1 inches, so we know that our area is going to be inches squared. So I'll plug in pi times 34.1, and that's squared. So that'll give us pi times 34.1 squared is 1162.81. So 1162.81 will get multiplied to pi. And when we multiply that to pi, we'll get 3653.07, which rounds to 3653.1. And we can't forget our units. If the radius was in inches, our area is in inches squared. 3653.1 inches squared. In number 7, our radius is 13.2 kilometers. So for area, area equals pi times r squared, where r is 13.2 kilometers, so we're squaring that quantity. That'll be pi times 13.2 squared is 174.24, so 174 and 24 hundredths kilometers squared. So when we multiply that quantity by pi, we'll get 547.39, which, rounding to the nearest tenth, is 547.4, and for area, we'll have kilometers squared. 547.4 kilometers squared for number 7. And lastly in this video, I'll go over number 8. However, before I work through the answer for this, please click that subscribe button. Also, while you're at it, click the like button as well. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated. Now, in number 8, they give us the radius r to be 29.9 kilometers. So for area, we're going to have pi times r squared, so that's pi times 29.9 kilometers, and that quantity squared. So that'll be pi times 29.9 squared is 894.01. So 894.01 kilometers squared. So we multiply 894 and 1/100 to pi, so 894.01 times pi, we'll get 2,808.61, which rounds to 2,808.6, and that's kilometers squared for the area in number 8. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. Continue on to the next video, where we'll go over the circumference of a circle. And as always, like, subscribe, and share this video with your peers.